My name is Seth Starner. I work for Amway Business Innovations team. And this is the second day of the alternate transportation workshop. And we started the morning with an exercise called Alternate Worlds. And the whole point is to go out and be inspired by something that's totally unrelated to, in this case, transportation. So today we talked to a supply chain manager, a specialist in electrical grids, a biologist, and an IT specialist. So between the four, they all have to deal in some form or another with transporting either products or information or electricity, or in the case of the body, nutrition or how to fight viruses or so on. It's all about transporting from A to B. And so we use those ideas or alternate worlds as inspiration to think about the concept that we're trying to solve for.
Hi, I'm Tom DeVries with Amway's Business Innovations Group. Here we have a creative matrix. So once we have a rich set of insight from going out into the field and understanding user empathy, interviewing people, looking at the context in which they live, alternative worlds give us an outside perspective, as Seth told you about. Now that we have the mindset in a really rich place, people naturally tend to transition into ideas. Their mind in alternative worlds exercise naturally transition into how can we think about this this problem differently. In order to accelerate that process, we use a method called creative matrix. So what we do is we take down one axis, enablers, and the other axis, behavior change. We force them to think about these in particular areas in really tight boxes and generate a whole bunch of ideas and get kind of a complete holistic sense of all different types of ideas and how they might mash these ideas up together to come up with a large volume of ideas in a really short period of time.
Tom already talked to you about the creative matrix and how it's a great way to promote divergent thinking. What I want to talk to you about now is another method for coming in and do more convergent thinking. A lot of good ideas in here. What are the better ones? What are the strongest ones? And what we use to do that is a great method called an importance difficulty matrix. It's a quad chart. On this axis here, what we have folks do is take their ideas and rank them relatively to each other by what they think is the most impactful to the least impactful. They're all good ideas, but what we want to know relative is, of all your ideas, what do we think is really going to move the needle? What do we think is really going to be powerful? Go through each concept and raise them up. Is that easy? Is that hard? So this idea of difficulty or cost, and what we end up with is this wonderful view on all our ideas. And what's nice about it is, if you see these kind of scattered here, is if we turn this into an actual quad, what we have here is the ideas down here are your better ideas. Why is that? Because they're the ideas that are the most impactful and the least difficult to implement, meaning these are your highest ROI. Up here, though, these are more your strategic ideas. These are ideas that are highly impactful, but they're going to be difficult, they're going to be time-intensive, they're going to be resource-intensive. Down here, we call these low-hanging fruit, the quick wins, right? These are things that are not that difficult, the least difficult. They're not that impactful, but, you know, they could move the needle. Anything that lands up here, what we're saying, these are our worst ideas. Why are they worst ideas? Well, because we're saying these are the most difficult and least impactful.
Hi, my name's Abby Wilson. I'm the director of public sector and nonprofit relations at the Luma Institute. So after finishing our importance difficulty matrix, which is a way of assessing the relative cost and value of the ideas that we've developed, we asked our various teams to do a cover story mock-up, which is a way of thinking creatively with the end in mind. So rather than just asking them to pitch an idea prospectively, you imagine that it has been successful and obtain theoretical quotes from the people who have actually experienced the success of this idea. The mock-up to my left, although the cover here is mostly an image, here inside this gives you greater detail about the actual details of the concept. Here we're closing down under-trafficked residential streets in order to permit bicycle use. So this cover story mock-up ends up becoming the jumping off point for a critique process. So in the process of delivering this artifact to their peers, they obtain valuable insights about the successes, problems, potential places for verification and clarification tomorrow. So going into tomorrow, we're going to take these relatively rough concepts and actually move into iterating on them and figuring out what works and what doesn't. So onward and upward.